was teaching second grade in Gabs, Nevada at the time. I was originally from Wyoming, and I decided that I would take an interview wherever I could get in Wyoming just to get back in the state. I pulled into the parking lot, and just in front of me was a white van that had pulled in and parked. I assumed that it was the janitors because they were unloading something out of their van.
After lunch, our teacher, Mrs. Sparks, would always read to us from a book. It would give us a chance after the noon recess to wind down, calm down, cool off, and so we could get back into the afternoon part of the school. We kept hearing the rumor that it was vaccination time, but we were looking at the clock and thinking, oh, maybe we'll get out of it, maybe it's not today.
I get out of my car, go into the building. I go to the office, and the man that I thought to be the janitor was standing at the office talking with the secretary, and so I walked up right next to him. He pulled the tool out of his tool belt, and he pointed it at my head, and I started laughing, and I said, oh, new job interview technique? The secretary, when I made my comment, she looked at me, and she was unblinking, and she had just literally a terrified look on her face, and she was as white as she could possibly be, and you could tell that something was desperately wrong. I was looking for cover, trying to decide which way I was going to run, and I was thinking to myself, is there somebody outside with guns? Are they going to shoot me when I get out the door or I get out the window? And I'm fixing to make my move, and the gal comes to the door, and she points again at me and says, don't do that. And then he said, you've just walked into the middle of a revolution. They're shepherding all the kids in the entire school into this room, and it just is getting more and more crowded. Nobody has a clue what's going on as they're being shepherded into the room.
After we'd all gotten in there, everybody was there, the principal stood up and we all quieted down. He told us he had to tell us what was going on. And so that's when he explained that we were being held hostage. We'd seen the news and, you know, planes had been taken hostage. We knew that this was not a good thing. Hostage was not fun. That was when we first realized that he had a bomb, what he was up to, and the amount of danger we were really in. They called a dead man switch because if they had shot him, somebody bumped him away, we attacked him, whatever happened, if he moved from that bomb, it would go off because he would pull the switch.
The adults in the room recognized who the hostage takers were as David and Doris Young. David had worked previously as the town sheriff.
He kept looking around. He was very observant of what was going on around him. He was watching the doors, watching for people to take off. At first, everybody kind of stayed away. But as we got more comfortable with him and the apparatus, the bomb that was there, we kind of got closer to him. And that really seemed to make David nervous.
He was worried that the kids might bump into his arm. And so he decided to put a magic square in the middle of the room and put the bomb and himself in the middle of the room.
His wife, the lady, was standing by the main door most of the time to keep people in. So that added to the problems in the room. You know, people wanted to leave, they didn't want to stay, but we couldn't, we were stuck. You know, we'd been in there for almost 3 hours, so he had to use the restroom. He called his wife over to him inside the magic square, and he untied the switch from his wrist, tied it onto hers. He walked through the kids, and we cleared a path for him, and he went to the bathroom.
I looked up, and Doris Young had taken David Young's place, and she was standing in the middle of the magic square with the dead man switch on the bomb. And she's kind of oblivious to reality. So she's holding that dead man switch on the bomb, and she is looking around, but she's not really engaged with anyone. One of the primary teachers had a child that had vomited, and she walked up to the magic square where Doris was holding the dead man switch, and she addressed Doris and said, "Can I clean this child up?" And as Doris turned to answer the question, she let go of the dead man switch. I jumped out the window, and I got about 3 steps away, and I got in a couple good breaths of air, and then I went back to the building, and we just kept grabbing hands. We were watching for their hands and screaming, "Come to the light, come to the light, come to the window," and the little hands would come out, and you'd grab a hold of the hands, and then we were just throwing them. My adrenaline was pumping so hard, I'm throwing them like little yard darts, and then all of a sudden, there's no more little hands. And so I was like, oh my gosh, all these kids are still in there.
David at that time had come out of the bathroom. He was standing in the doorway, and he had a pistol in each hand, and he was firing. So I just turned and I said, "I'm gonna go, maybe I'll get lucky." And I went for it. As I got in the hallway there, I looked down and there was a student on the ground. I remember I went to lean over to pick her up. I knew I was in, it was a bad situation, but I didn't want to leave somebody. But I got pushed from behind, I had to jump over him, and I just went with the flow. The push out was so great, I just had to go.
I thought that there were dead kids in that room because I knew how bad the smoke was. And if they didn't get burned, the smoke inhalation, you just were gonna not make it. Then I saw that there were a lot more kids that were outside than what I had imagined could have come through that window. And at that point I realized that there were 2 other exits.
The way I understand it was he was going to create like a new world order type plan. He was going to take us all to this afterlife where there was no violence and no governments and everything was happy and peaceful. To go to that from blowing everybody up in a tragic, terrible death, how he expected to go to peace and tranquility, I'll never know.